WGN Radio honors Vietnam veterans.
My name is Diana Hackbarth. I was born in Chicago, and I currently live in Wilmette. And I was a Navy nurse during the Vietnam conflict, so I was recruited during my sophomore year at Loyola University Chicago School of Nursing. So I was already an officer in my junior and senior year at Loyola, and then I owed the Navy 3 years of service. Many of the techniques that we now use to take care of trauma patients were developed during Vietnam. So the way that it worked is the Navy and the Army trained corpsmen, and so the corpsmen and the Navy then went with the Marines. The Army had similar types of people. So what happened was the corpsmen were right embedded in the troops, and as soon as anybody was injured, the corpsmen ran out and immediately provided first aid or immediate services, and as quickly as possible, people were lifted off the battlefield, brought back behind the lines, and if possible, were put on a helicopter and then taken to a safer place. What I recall is when I came back, as I'm sure many of the Vietnam vets will tell you, that we were not welcomed with open arms or with parades because there was such negative feelings about the war and really negative feelings about many of the military who served. And there was, you know, pictures on the news of the Malay massacre and things like that. So I just remember that I sort of kept quiet about my military service unless asked. But I also, again, you know, I didn't do anything I was ashamed of, nor was I in a position to do anything harmful. So I don't have some of the same feelings, I think, that some of those other people do, that they made a huge sacrifice and that they were unrecognized for that. But I do agree that our VA system was not well equipped. So we had many young guys, as you know, they had head injuries, they had amputations, they were, you know, paralyzed, had post-traumatic stress disorder, and I don't think that was well recognized. So I still think that we see some of the sequelae to that today. I think that I served because I wanted to do good. I felt it was the Kennedy era. I felt I wanted to do something for my country. And I think if I hadn't become a nurse in the military, I probably would have gone into the Peace Corps. So I think my motivation was not so much that I believed in the war, but that I thought it was important as a nurse to make a contribution to society and to my country, and so therefore I, you know, went into the Navy.
On the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War, we give tribute to those who have always deserved it. Proudly brought to you by the United Association's Veterans and Piping Program.